Yo, 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 it's Malik, and you're here with Botsam and the Mandem. And on today's topic, we're going to talk about the way Chris Eubank Jr. addressed Conor Benn about his tough six-round fight he had earlier in the month. Many will say that it was uncalled for to make it public, especially where Conor Benn has actually warned him about that and asked him on numerous occasions, if you want to give me any candid advice, DM me or call me. I don't actually particularly see it that way. I feel that Chris Eubank is not just talking to him, but talking to a lot of fighters coming up about the dangers of the sport. A lot of people, a lot of fighters in his time, close friends, left the boxing game ruined, with no money and no legacy. You know what I mean? They got robbed by their promoters. Their promoters treated their career badly by putting them in fights where they were tough and never actually allowed them to build up their profile and, you know, make some serious money. And if they're going to take risk, get paid what they're supposed to get for that risk. Not saying that the fight Conor Benn took was a risk, but maybe he took one too many fights in this year. You know what I mean? And Chris Eubank warned him about that, that he needed to be close with his father because his father obviously has been in the sport and has made a lot of money and probably is the reason why he is in the sport. You know what I mean? I think people underrate what Chris Eubank Sr. does for Junior. In many ways, if Chris Eubank Sr. left it to the promoters, I don't think Eubank would have had the success he's had now. Many of you might not consider what he's had with the belt being successful, but let's think about it. Without any promoter, this guy has, in his next fight, is going to earn more than £10 million. Now, I think any boxer that's able to do that is successful, you know what I mean? And he did it without a promoter. It was just him and his manager. So I think Chris Eubank, there's a bit of malicious because obviously he's a Ben. But at the same time, when you really look at all his mates and all the people that came up at the same time, there's only a few boxers that can say that, yeah, they made a living off this or they could walk away from boxing on their own terms. You know what I mean? What happens to the rest? What happens to their lives? You know what I mean? The ones that put their blood, sweat and tears into this thing, you know what I mean? So it's a bit nuts that obviously he's getting a bit of backlash, but I think people need to really think of it as it's not Chris Eubank talking to me, it's just advice, you know what I mean? And they, any, everyone could benefit from someone who's actually been in the field. And a lot of trainers, and I've said this on many occasions, a lot of trainers ain't fighters. 99% of trainers ain't fighters. And they might not know exactly how it feels and what is required for you to get through tough times, you know what I mean? And leaving it all to what the trainer says is not always a good idea, you know what I mean? You're putting, it's like putting your life in someone that has no business in your field. Yes, he's a trainer, but like Chris Eubank says, they're no different to a PE teacher. So yeah, I just wanted to see what your thoughts are on it. What do you think? Do you think it was harsh that he did say that? Do you think he should have not made it public? Do you think it's a good thing to do? And also, you know, bring light to this where promoters are exploiting fighters. You know what I mean? And they've been doing this historically. We saw this with a lot of people's careers. Even the great Mike Tyson was exploited. The guy made $500 million in career earnings and filed for bankruptcy. It's insane that you can, boxers can make this type of money and still go bust. Where did the money go? You know what I mean? A lot of these great boxers died broke. A lot of these boxers didn't even make money from boxing. You know what I mean? You get me on? So, it is what it is. But that's enough from me. Boxing with the Mandem. It's Malik. I'm out.